Welcome back to another Urban Influencer episode. You can find us on Instagram, YouTube, and at theurbaninfluencer.com. I'm your host, Aaliyah, and today we have a very special guest with us. We have Splash Rob.
What's poppin'? What's good?
What up? Hi, how are you? Good. So tell us a little bit about yourself to get started. Like, where'd your name come from? Like, who is Splash Rob?
Oh, yeah. So my name actually came from my first song, you feel me, that I recorded called Swag Splash. And then, like, everybody, you know, everybody knew me in, like, high school and stuff, for real, so it's like, everybody already knew me. So I was just like, Rob, like, oh, that's Rob, Black Rob. Then once I came with the Swag Splash song, it went from Black Rob to Splash Rob, so that's how we got that. But yeah, I've been throwing parties, hosting parties, you feel me, since, like, 2008, 2009. And they finally started giving me a little bit of my respect around this time.
Yeah, for sure.
And this time, you feel me? And then over here, a little bit. So like 2016, like I had the longest running Saturday night in the city consistently, like back to back to back to back to back to back. For 3 years straight though, like, and every year I just be making like music that's going along with the time and the sound of music at the time, like,
yeah,
because I always had the studio and work with people that had the studio. It's like my bros did music, I was the promoter, you feel me, they was the artist, he was the engineer, this person was the merchandise person, and now we done just elevated to where we just doing all type of stuff for real, like we making everything, like we got our own building, we got our own studio, and we just building. That's growth.
Well, that's what you got to do as an artist. You know, you got to continually work on your brand. You got to continue to grow. Also got to continue to make sure, you know, you bring the people who are with you from the start along, you know? So I completely understand that. So how did you get started, like, music-wise? Like, was it just one day you decided, you know what, I'm going to drop this hit real quick, or...
No, actually, like, I was just, like, I was already cool, but it's, like, I used to play basketball and stuff. So, it was, like, I used to play basketball, but then, like, one day I had fucked my wrist up trying to dunk at the court. Then it was just, like, it was over with from there. Like, my wrist be popping still to this day. But now, it's, like, yeah, my dude... from my hood, my dude, A. Rich, he was rapping in the hood, you feel me, had the fly car, feel me, girls, I was like, hold on, man, this basketball stuff don't work out, I might have to go ahead and see what's up, I'm like, man, let me get on the track, like, and then he was popping, like, then, because they had their own group at that time, I was, like, probably, like, I was young as hell at that time, so it was, like, I probably might have been like 13, 14 seeing it, but then I ain't trying to like actually do something till 16. They like, man, no, I can't just be doing anything with anybody. Like, man, I'm popping. You got to work on your stuff. I'm like, all right, I'm going to be good enough to hop on the track with him. So then it went from that to now. Yeah. It's like, oh, he lit.
Yeah, no, that makes a lot of sense. I was just talking with another artist how culturally, you know, basketball and music are so connected, and you know how you see a lot of basketball players now, you know, getting into the rap game and trying to like work on their flow and develop their songs. So yeah, no, I totally get that. And as you showed us earlier, you know, you're trying to develop your brand, you're trying to work on getting into different avenues and different lanes, and I read in your bio that you not only consider yourself, you know, a music artist, you know, you've been working on some acting, you've been doing some producing, you know, you DJ, you host. So like, tell us a little bit about having your hands in all those different, you know.
Yeah, because like I said, by me being a promoter,
that was like a cheat code because I was like the best promoter. Like my way of promoting at first, I used to like on Facebook and Facebook days and MySpace days. I was promoting back then. So it was like Facebook. It was at one point in time, you make an event and you could send a bunch of people messages that you invited.
Yeah.
So I had mastered that. I'm like, once I figured that out, I was like, oh, you'll wake up with like 60, 100 messages all from me about the same event. So it's like, once I figured out how to do that and mastered the groups and stuff, everybody ain't had no choice but to know who I was. So by people knowing my name already so much, people wanted me to be a part of stuff.
Yeah.
So then I could be a part of, you got to have Slash talking about it. If Slash ain't talking about it, then it ain't hot. You feel me? Oh, Slash got the parties. He got to be shouting it out at his party. He got to be, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, it became, like, it's like, in my city, I'm already a household name before I even attached the music to it. So it's like, I just basically built my brand. I built my brand before I even attached the music to it because you already support, like, the brand. So it's like, I'm standing behind whatever he do. It don't even matter. Whatever you're doing, I'm with.
No, for sure. It's definitely important to, you know, build that local fan base because, you know, the people who were loyal to you from the get-go is your city, you know? Yeah. That's how you work it up to becoming big and you build it up. So what was it? I know it said that you were in Heights Girl 2 and you were also like an associate producer. So what was it like acting and working on that project? Like, are you thinking about doing more movies? Like,
yeah, no, we got more stuff in the works for sure. Like, I'm a natural with it. Like, my dude was like, hey, man, if they don't try and give you no deal or once you done doing a music thing, like, you for sure got a lane in this. Like, this is your, like you funny without trying to be funny. Like,
right.
And it's so many people that try to be funny, but it don't come off that way. Like, but yeah, like, all my, I be improv acting. Every time he's like, man, I ain't even had no scenes in high school. Like, I ain't had no lines. I had to be like, man, just go do something. This is what you about to do. You just about to be in a shootout. And then I'm like, all right. Then he like, man, we was editing it. And then we went back and looked over. We seen you had pulled your phone out in the middle of the shootout. Like, we about to go back in and do that part again and edit it. He's like, bro, that's genius. I ain't never seen that. And then that became one of their favorite parts in the movie. And then, like I said, with the promoting, as far as me being a promoter, I wear so many hats, I could just put them on at any time.
Exactly.
So it's like, it ain't no middleman with me, for real, for real. I done cut out every middleman in my life. I make my own flyers, make my own graphics, make my own, DJ my own party, host my own party. It's just like everybody had to go. Cause then got tired. I was even a cameraman at one point in time. See my own videos, I edit it. I know how to do all that.
Right. So, and that goes off of, you know, you just being yourself and like being willing to put on these different hats and put yourself out there and get creative, like really get creative.
Yeah.
So what would you say your music creative process is like? Is there like, do you like go out and drive for a while until inspiration hits you? Like, what's that process like when you're developing a song?
I got to hear the beat. I'm more like, if I know what my voice sounds good on. So it's like, I already done mastered my craft. And now that I got my voice down back, because like when you starting out, you feel me? You just trying all different type of stuff. Try this, try that. Once an auto tune came out, everybody played with the auto tune a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But then it's like, no, I need to find me where I'm comfortable, like to where I'm not getting on the track and sounding like, Future did it. It didn't sound like this. I should do it like Future, or I should be like this person. Like, no, I'm coming on. It's me. And once I got comfortable with that, I know what beats I sound good on, and I know what beats I don't. So if it don't come off, like, if it don't sound like a hit, I don't even want to be on it, for real, honestly.
Right.
Like, I ain't even about to waste my time even going into it. Because most of my songs, I just go off of feeling and melody, for real, for real. I listen to the beat, catch the melody, and then put words on top of the melody after I catch it.
Yeah, no, that makes complete sense. Are you working with a specific sound engineer? Are you doing it yourself? Are you, like, freestyling?
Yeah, no,
like,
I got two engineers I work with. And I got a team of producers I work with. My engineers I work with, Dane B and Ron Engineering. They the top engineer, they the top, and that's all you feel me, built from the ground up. We all bros, you feel me? We grew up into this shit together. So it's like, we all used to stay together and everything. So it's like, as everybody elevate and grow, we all go together, but we still locked in. Everybody got their own situation. Everybody their own boss, you feel me? Ain't nobody under nobody.
Yeah, you definitely, you're bringing those people along who keep you grounded, you know, it helps you. It maintains that friendship over years, and like, they're the people who know you best, they're the people who work with you best. So like, I definitely understand that. I know you mentioned a little bit about, you know, matching your voice to the beat and really making sure it's you, it projects you. I can already tell you have a big personality. So like, what's your favorite song to perform?
My favorite song to perform, I mean, right now, I'm going crazy with right now. Like, I'm straight tunnel vision on that. I don't want to give them nothing else to pay attention to. Like, I got other songs, other hits, all that. But right now, I need you to focus on right now. Like, don't pay attention to nothing. I'm like, all right, I'll do a little clip. No, right now, that's what I need you to focus on. Because it's like, yeah, that's what's getting me these doors unlocked and networking. And once they, like, you got to get people like stuck. People's attention span so short, you could throw five things at them and then they ain't even going, they listen to a whole mixtape. You listen to a whole mixtape, 10 songs, you only going to remember one. So it's like, you might as well put that energy towards that one song. And right now I'm going crazy, but right now I'm in the strip clubs with it and the regular clubs with it.
That makes a lot of sense.
I got a finesse down pat, because it's like, and then how I perform, it ain't no average, you know what I'm saying? I'm not no dancer type dude. I ain't about to get up there and
you're not gonna bust no moves? Okay.
Yeah, no, I ain't gonna get up there and embarrass myself and get the tune bugging and Millie rocking. I don't do it for that. Like, I make music for people that make money and people that get money. And if you ain't either one of them two, you ain't even gonna relate to the shit that I'm talking about.
Well, listen, you know your audience. You gotta stick to what you know. You gotta stick to what you know.
Yeah.
Don't be on your side. You gotta, you know, follow that. That'll bring you success in whatever you do, as long as you're true to yourself and you have the passion for it. And like, speaking of right now, congratulations. You have over 115,000 listens on Spotify. You got yourself on a playlist. Like, you really are blowing it up. So what was like, how did Right Now come about? Like, did you just hear the beat and you're like, no, this is it. This is it. I got it.
No, I was actually, I heard the beat. I'm trying to think, hold on, how did I actually come up with?
Because I listened to it, it's a bop. I can totally see this in the clubs being a hit.
But yeah, I was leaving the strip club. And it's like crazy, because it's like, not all the time I'd be like in a mood to do music for real, for real.
Right.
So it's like, I'm leaving a strip club. I got this idea in my head, like, all right, boom, boom. And then like, literally I searched for the beat on YouTube. I just type in a certain type, like, oh, this type beat. And then it had came up. Then I'm like, oh, this go right with it, lightweight. But then it was like certain instruments that was in the sound. Cause I'm a voice memo dude. I'm voice memo the hell out.
You gotta, when it comes to you, you gotta get it. You gotta write it down right when that happens. You can't wait, cause then you'll forget. So I definitely get the best voice memos.
Yeah, no, the voice memo. I feel like a lot of people in the game doing that now too, though. I'm gonna wipe my camera off. Man. You need to see all my dark skinness. You know what I'm saying? But
yes, black is beautiful.
Yeah, but I'm up there. I'm doing it in a spot. Oh, this hard. But like I said, I need to get a couple of instruments out of there. So I'm like, man, I gotta buy this beat. And then at the time, I think Booty was like a big record right then. Black Yellowstone Booty was a big record then. So I'm like, no, there's more of the lane of that. Like, oh, then I will hit Just the Engineer up. Like, man, I need exclusive rights to this, man. What you want for it? You tell me the price, got it. Gave me the track outs, took it to the studio, took some stuff out, got my boy Ryan Engineer, and it was over with from there.
It was a lockdown.
I took it straight to the strip club.
You locked it right down. Well, that's how you test it out. You know, you take it. You take it to those clubs. You play it for them. That's how you know, it's hit quality. You play it in those strip clubs. You play it in the clubs. People dancing. You know, you got something.
Yeah, you said how many plays this song? I ain't even checked it.
So on Spotify, I checked it today actually. On Spotify, you got over 115,000 listens. Like you got over 100. Yeah.
Ooh, that's crazy. Independent. Who would have ever thought?
Right.
Being from Cleveland, Ohio, but we Cleveland on the way though. We got some pressure. Yeah.
Cleveland, you know, it's always been, you got a couple great music artists, a lot of them out of Cleveland, Ohio. You know, you got, I believe Kid Cudi's out there. You got Bone Thugs and Harmony, Tracy Clapman. Yeah.
Boy right now. Yeah.
Cleveland's out here for sure. Yeah. So like, speaking of performances, like take us back to like one of your first music performances. Like how were you feeling?
Party.
Were you hyped?
My birthday
were you nervous?
Party. I was lit. It was my birthday party, you feel me? It was one of the original first, like literally one of the first promo videos in the city. Like, cause I started out like, man, how can everybody, I need to figure out a way to get everybody to want to know who I am. Right. Like everybody know who I am for real, like at school, but this, and the teen clubs, this is different. So I'm like, man, I'm gonna take people pictures and then they gonna have to come to my page afterwards. So I'm in there. I was the picture dude at first, like, oh, because everybody had cameras. Cameras, right. People don't even realize, like, cameras used to be expensive back then. And you had a camera, man. You was like, oh.
It wasn't just the iPhone. You had the gear. Yes.
This back when they had the blue Kyoceras and shit. So it's like, oh, he got a camera. Take my picture. And I post them all on the MySpace. So I'm like, I got a camera I took it to school one day. Like, man, say you're gonna be at my birthday party November 1st is about to go down. Like, everybody
marketing yourself, yes,
yeah. So, it was like 12 minutes long, just everybody saying the whole school, oh, I'm gonna be there. Y'all already know what it's gonna do. Da, 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 da. So, then I get there, it's like 11:45. My birthday was at 12. Get there. The line all the way down is in the plaza. It's long as hell. So it's like, man, gotta get in there. So we had to go through the back door. I'm like, told y'all what I was about to do. Boom, boom, boom. I think this was like one of the last parties there for real. Like it actually shut down the club.
Wow.
Like, so it was like my first like main big performance. Birthday party, and I shut down the club. So it was like, ever since then, it was like my birthday party was just like a staple. And I went in there, did my little two-step, hit them with it. Everybody went crazy on my part. I got it on YouTube to this day.
That's awesome.
Everybody get to scream. Once I just grab the mic, the energy just in the room just go up to a whole nother level. So it was like, but me being brought in by the right people, you know what I'm saying? That played a big part too, for real. Cause it's like, I didn't do it by myself.
Right.
So it's like, I'm always going to give big ups to my boys, man.
For sure. And I know you were saying like that feeling that music drives you and, you know, the audience reaction and being up there and feeling that energy. So what would you say was the moment you knew like, oh yeah, I'm being music for a while. Like, I know you talked a lot about promoting and stuff like that, but like, what was it, a concert? Was it that feeling itself?
Yeah, no, like it was just like that feeling in that room. Like, man, Cleveland, if Cleveland don't like nothing, they gonna let you know. Like, Cleveland don't gravitate towards, like, bro, this is one of the hardest crowds to get people over.
They're like, we're not warming up to you. It's now or never.
Yeah, and everybody doing the same thing. So, like, everybody rapping. So, it's like, yeah, y'all better not turn up to they shit harder than our shit. Like, it be going on for real. So, it's like, if people actually, and then we had, like, a little two-step dance with the whole club was doing it. Like, so it's like, for us to get that type of reaction off that song, it was like, oh. Like, I know for a fact we got something, but it was my song. And it's like, oh, shit. Like, this it. And I add a whole different type of vibe. My vibe that I come with is different. Like, right now ain't my first hit that I would say for real. But it's just something that caters to the people that come to my events.
Broader. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a broader audience for real. Like, niggas, you go to showcases and everything. Like, dudes go sit in the front. Dudes are sitting in the front just me, even if it's hard. Like, man, this shit hard, but I ain't about to let this nigga know it's hard. He ain't gonna think I'm on his dick. Everybody look at support like you big ride, but it's not big ride. You just like, it's okay to like some shit, my nigga. You ain't gotta be gangster all the time, but it's like, yeah. But the main people to get to like music, and the main consumers is kids and females.
Right. Yeah.
So if you cater to them and get it to be like, all right, if it's a song that females gonna like or kids gonna like, you got a great ass potential of blowing up because they're gonna listen to it over and over again. They're gonna play it no matter who they around. Yeah. Like making music for dudes is cool, but it's just like ain't got nothing to do with no guns and shooting and killing somebody. It's like,
right.
We ain't trying to hear that. We ain't trapping, we ain't robbing, we ain't like I'm selling fun for real. So it's like it's a difference. Like that's cool, but like I'm coming to the party. Hey, what up? I'm
Splash, we here bro. To turn up. Yeah.
We here to turn up. I make music for the ladies, man. Y'all keep doing that thug shit. That's cool. But I'm about to make them twerk while y'all do whatever it is.
For sure. And like knowing that, you know, you have that audience, you have that group, knowing people rock with you, like how would you say your fans would describe your music? Like, how do you want your fans to describe your music?
Turn up, like turn up music. It's party music. Like it's the whole brand. Like, a party with Splash, you can listen to my song and be like, nah, this need to be lit. He need to turn up. And like I said, like right now ain't nothing but basically a twerk contest wrapped out.
Yes.
And on YouTube, that's like the biggest video that I got is a twerk contest that we had hosted. And it got like close to, like on Facebook, it went viral. Same night, like night of went viral. They had like 50,000 one night. Woke up, it was gone. Like, damn, that bitch was gone. Like, man, we gotta put it on YouTube. And right now, that motherfucker like over 90,000 views. And that shit happened, like, yeah. So it was like, all it is a twerk contest, just hosted and wrapped out instead of just being like, oh, all right, da 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 da. Because it's just different elements. But then by me being a DJ, it helped me out too.
Yeah.
Because I got to learn like certain little structures of, I got cheat codes. I learned the BPMs, you feel me?
Yeah.
And 72, that go into anything. 72 could be up to 74. You could crank it to 76, 77, you know what I'm saying? Or you can flip it to the 144s and the 140s and the 130s. Like, man, I got the cheat codes with that. And then I just broke it down into four. I do all my songs to where it's like, I write them in fours for real, because them the loops.
Yeah.
So it don't matter where you put, you know what I'm saying, the loop at on the where it be even, it's gonna always be like, oh, that's hard. That's a whole nother song right there. That's another song. Like I done flip right now into probably like three different songs after this, for real.
Right. And it's clear from having this conversation, just from the stories you tell me, you really know how to market, promote yourself, you know, push your brand out there, from your birthday party to like the contest to the DJing and learning all the trades. Like you really in this industry for real to like uplift, support, to party. So knowing all that and knowing you used to promote, like what if you weren't in music? And I know you talked a little bit about basketball too. Like if you weren't in music, like what would you be doing? Like what would your focus be on?
I'd be making money. I'm making money doing something.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get some money. You know, one thing about me that all my boys tell you, like, nah, nigga gonna hustle, man. Nigga gonna make some money. For sure. Like, yeah. I put the whole this bitch ass train, man.
It's all right. I can still hear you.
But yeah, no, like one of the like most important parts of like our story for real, whenever our unsung come and our documentary get told, then everybody gonna be like, nah, like it was at one point, like I ain't worked a job since I worked at White Castle, you feel me?
Yeah.
I tried the little job thing, 16, 15. You know what I'm saying? I'm up there promoting parties through the drive-thru. And then they just cut my hours one day. Like, man, I don't like this shit. Like, I'm in here trying to work to make as much money as possible. I'm getting paid every week. Then they turn around and just cut my hours and gave me one day. But then I finessed it. You feel me? And people started giving me their hours because everybody, I'm everybody's name. It's me. It's the boy. So they like, oh, you want to work with me this day? You can work. Boom, you want to work with me this day? So then I end up still getting more hours than they just
out here hustling.
They end up eventually letting me go though. But after that, I'm like, man, I don't like people being in control of what the fuck.
Like what you're in control of your work schedule, so, how you make your money. Yeah. Going to business yourself.
So I'm like, man, I'm doing this party shit. I'm making more money in a party in 4 hours.
Your next than 9 to 5 week. Right.
So why the fuck? Once I got that mindset, I'm like, man, like 3-4 years in, my dudes, they up here working at Cleveland Clinic and they on child support and giving, like, man, hold on, bro, you making shirts. Like, look at me, bro. I ain't worked a job since I was 16. Y'all done seen me not work a job. I'm doing pretty damn good, man.
You said if I'm going to business for myself, parties, right?
You know what I'm saying? If I could do this off of parties, you could do this off of making shirts. I'm like, bro, you make one shirt for $20, $25.
Right.
But you working for $10 an hour.
Yep. And you definitely got that. And you got that, like, can't nobody promote you better than yourself. Like, who knows you better than yourself? You got that.
Yeah, I'm like, they already know us. Then I'm like, my dude got the studio. I'm like, man, like, Miami.
I'm still loving that you were working at White Castle telling everybody when to come through, promoting as you handed in their food. You're like, listen, while I'm helping you, come through, come see me.
Yeah, like, they already knew what was up. Because it's like, I got a signature look, you feel me? Like, I was one of the first ones with the hawk, you feel me?
Yeah.
But like, you're done turning the dreads back here. It's like a mohawk.
Yeah.
With a fade on the side, though. But I used to have waves, too, though. So it was like, you know what I'm saying? I was always, and they loved me forever, for real. But you know, the love come with hate. So
always,
I be having to deal with the blackballness too. Because it's a flip side. It's a good side, and then it's a bad side. Right. You know what I'm saying? I won strip club DJ of the year, my first year in DJing.
Wow.
So just think about how that made every other DJ feel.
And it was like,
and it was like, on top of that, it was like voted on by like, it wasn't like, oh, vote. It was like voted on by the dancers.
Wow, yeah. So this comes from the people.
In-house. Yeah. It's coming from real people in-house. And they like, boom. Once when I won that, them niggas boxed me out of the strip club.
As more successful as you get, you know, you got those people who are rooting for you to fail. They're looking at your success like, oh, I can't get that. So they can't like, match that level.
Not even a real DJ. This nigga's I'm getting all that.
Instead of uplifting you, they're going to look to root for you to fail. But, you know, as long as you know yourself, you stay true to yourself, true to who you are, like, they can't touch you.
I'm the rebel in the city, you feel me? Against all eyes, I'm out here like 300. Everybody linking up, teaming up, and going against me. And I'm still, you feel me?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm still, like, against all that, you feel me? Teams and promoters, all that, everybody. You got the promoters. Then you got the DJ.
You got the artist.
Then you got the club owner. Like, everybody, man, what the hell? No, this nigga think he about to da-da-da-da-da. Even the graphic designers. Oh, yeah. This nigga doing flyers for $40, $50. I'm charging. Oh, like, yeah. So it's like, I got to overcome all that and to still get support and have people rocking. Like, that's a bigger statement. Me making it is a way bigger statement than just, like, having a good ass.
Exactly.
Oh. He got to go, no, it's a whole thing behind
it.
It's
a whole movement.
Shit.
Yeah, as long as you got the people behind you, you got your fans behind you.
And the crazy part is, I really know how to, like my nigga say, like, this dumbed down for me, for real. Like, right now, dumbed down for me. But it's like,
well, yeah.
It's simple, but it's like, I know how to rap for real. I get in there and say some shit that make a motherfucker be like, oh, but people are not trying to hear that. Niggas not trying to think and be drunk at the same time. Like, oh, what did you say? Like, no, nah, just turn up, take a shot, shake some ass, you know what I'm saying? All right, that's what I like. But once I reel them in and like, I get deep, I get deep. Yeah, I can say some fly shit and I can motherfucking have you in your feelings. I make mood music, whatever mood, you feel me? I want you to feel some type of
you
way.
You want people to relate to that. You want people to be able to connect with that. As somebody who, you know, has been in music for so long, DJing, being an artist, promoting, hosting, like, who would you say has been one of your biggest musical influences?
Yeah, musical influences. Shit, Soulja Boy, 50 Cent. Soulja Boy, 50 Cent, Diddy, Gucci. Shit, even 2 Chainz.
Yeah. It's
2 Chainz, some motherfuckers, it ain't never too late.
That's, you know what, true. I'm saying? Yeah.
And once you get your run, take off.
Exactly. So, like, who would you say, like, you were listening to growing up? Like, let me switch it up a little bit. Because, you know, you got the artist now. Okay.
Gucci. Front to back, since Hard to Kill, I've been listening to Gucci.
All right, shit. You out here? Yeah.
That's all you could listen to it in the hood. Gucci, OJ, who else? Jeezy. Motherfucker. I mean, you had your Lil Wayne moments, you know what I'm saying, and all that, but it's just like, I wasn't influenced by the, like, the,
yeah,
the jeans, I mean, the earrings here and all that, like, and all of it. That was, like, for the alternative kids.
Right, yeah.
But he was hard. No, don't get me wrong. Like, musically, but I look at it, like, all the way around. Like, I don't just look at it like music. I look at it like who you is as a person, how you carry yourself, all that matters.
Exactly. For real. Not just what you're, you know, putting out, not just the music, but, like, what's your story? Yeah. What's your motivation behind it? Like, what are you doing?
Because motherfuckers look at Diddy like, oh, Diddy ain't no rapper for real. He just da-da-da-da-da. But it's like, shit, that nigga influence is way better than his music. Yeah. Like, shit, I ain't about to be putting out all these goddamn hits. And now you think I'm not about to hop in one of these motherfuckers? Right. You think I ain't about to up?
Take the show.
Like, I know they every time they seen that shit, damn, this nigga. And it's like, yeah, like, and he started out shit. The ones that started out in the background and then ended up in the forefront, is the ones that's the type of people I like to represent. That's the type of people I like to look up to. Them type of people. You feel me? Because that's me. I done started from here and brought it to there. Like, oh damn, like, you do everything. Like, yeah, like, and you know this, like, you know my story, you know what's going on. Like,
so, like, knowing, like, who's influenced you, looking at who's influenced you and looking at who you, you know, grew up listening to, who would your dream feature be? Like, who would you love, you know, if they said, listen, SpongeBob, I want to get on this with, like, who is your dream feature? I know it's a tough question.
For real. Because the thing is, though, with music, it ain't about you. For real. It's about what the people like. So exactly. It's like, shit, me, though, I mean, I gotta do something with Gucci.
I was gonna say, give, like, me, like, who you work with, and then give me who you will work with, like, who your dream feature will be, like, for the band.
I mean, according to everybody, like, it would be crazy not to say Drake. You feel me? Like, Drake. Like,
he's,
like,
he, oh, hit maker. Guy. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, but yeah, like, shit. Like, Drake, Gucci. Who the hell else I've been listening to? Oh, Money Man. So, me and Money Man.
Okay. Are they on your, like, current playlist? You got them?
Yeah. Money Man. Queued up. Money Man, for sure. Like, Money Man, one of them slept on, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I said it in my last interview before that, like, every interview I done did. Like, I be listening to Money Man for sure. Like, to the original, you could tell when somebody sounded like somebody else. So it's like, it's a, come
right.
on.
Right. You could tell when they trying to piggyback off of the sound or what they think is trending right now.
Like, yeah, like. And everybody, like, it's a lot of artists that be doing, either they trying to do the Rod Wave. I listen to Rod Wave too, though. But either they trying to do the Rod Wave.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? They trying to do the Money Man, or they trying to do this Detroit sounding vibe.
Yeah.
But I'm sticking to my lane. I got a song on to them, but it's more so, like, for the females. But my shit is not that. Like, my shit is... You know what I'm saying? It's my real voice. Like, like, people hear me and it'd be crazy that I know how to, like way project my shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But it's like, yeah, like, this is me. And then people still come up to me. Like, it'd be like, I'm like, I leak, because I just leak stuff throughout my party. So it's like, let me see how they're gonna react to this. All right, exactly. Let me see how they're gonna react to this. Oh, like, who's this? What's this?
I heard this. Always trying to bring something new, exactly.
And then like, yeah, that's me, nigga.
Yeah, but that's like, unexpected. Keep them on their toes. Exactly. Yeah. So what's something that, you know, your fans might not know about you?
They might not know. I don't know. Everybody think I'm mean. No, they know I'm funny as hell. They know I'm funny as shit.
You a comedian.
Shit, I can type without looking. Nah, they probably know I can type without looking. I'll be on that net. I don't know. I mean, they probably don't know that I be making my own, you know what I'm saying? My own shit. You know what I'm saying? And designing this shit and making this shit look as good as it look. Like,
you out here being a whole fashion designer. I see
Yeah,
you.
Like, and they probably don't, I mean, they pretty much look at, I don't know though, that's crazy though. I ain't never think of that. Like, I'm out here, they probably don't. I know something that they don't know.
Okay, I'm ready.
Just hit. They don't know and won't know, probably won't ever know, that I was DoorDash.
Okay.
Food at the same time.
Oh my gosh.
Some of them orders did not make it.
No.
Some of them orders did not make it.
Listen, I DoorDash last night. And I was like, it took them a while. I was like, where is my food at? Come through. No.
But see, I was doing it at a time. Like, now it's like way a little bit safer to DoorDash. You know, they staple the bags and tape them and do all that. See, they wasn't doing that then when I was doing it. I got the game early.
You were trying to show people that they don't care. They just send it out.
I did that for a little minute on the side hustle on the downtime, like once some shit start, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, man, I can't just be waiting to DJ. I do that Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I still got, you know what I'm saying, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday.
You still got these other days. Yeah.
Then I went under somebody else's name. I was incognito.
Oh my God.
Then it was like everybody was telling me, like, man, you should do a show, bro. Like, you should make it a show. But I wasn't like thinking for real, bro. I'm like, I'm just out here getting some money.
Out here, Instagramming it. Oh Lord.
But they people would be like, man, what? Like, Splash, door that. Man, right. Splash, just drop
it. It would be crazy.
Off.
That's a whole TikTok moment.
Flyers and business cards in the inside. Yeah.
Oh no.
I'm on the same drive-through swag, just like, man.
Not dropping business cards in it, too.
Yeah, they like, look who dropped my food off. And then they Instagram and shout me out. I'm like, shit.
That's how you do it. And not the eating food part, but the putting your business cards out there with it.
Yeah, now you already agreed to it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you'll take a fry. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going crazy, like, drinking somebody pop.
Because
then I had learned that, like, I could just add a couple extra stuff on once they did the card. I could add my own stuff on to whatever they ordered, and then they'll come out my check. Yeah. I'm ordering me something, too. We both about to eat. So your food is safe and mine is, yeah.
Oh, my God. I see you not with DoorDash no more. That might be for the best.
Nah, I ain't. Yeah. But you can always trust me, though.
You say that after you be eating people's food, you be adding to the order. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
And another thing, though, like, that people don't know, like, I don't be trying to be late on purpose. Like, shit really be happening. Like, things popping up, shit be getting missing and shit. Like, keys would be in my pocket, and next thing you know, they end up somewhere else. Like, I just had these keys right here. How did they move by themselves?
I can't.
Like, something happened.
At least you true. You know, you honest. You honest. Yeah. That's a whole stand-up routine. You might have comedy in the future, you know?
No, I'm telling you.
The whole DoorDash, that's a whole comedy routine. You know, you might be out here in the club, in a comedy clubs with your own little set next, you know?
Yeah, no, they tried to get me to do some, like, improv type shit. Like, oh, who want to come up here and tell some jokes? Like, man, just get up here and talk, bro. Everybody going.
Oh, my. Oh, yeah, all you got to do is get up and talk, you know? Tell your stories. That is hilarious. Oh, my God. I'm sure you got some stories from White Castle, too. That is so funny.
Yeah, no, I got some White Castle stories. I got a Trapped in the Closet story, too. Shit.
Listen, we'll be waiting for... I'm waiting for that stand-up DVD, the Netflix special. I'll be waiting for it. Splash Rouse.
Like the untold stories of Splash.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah,
no, that is so funny. So, like, what is either the best advice that you've received or just... the best advice you would give, you know, somebody trying to come up and make it?
I mean, I'm always giving advice, you feel me, to the youngest. Just, I always tell them, like, if you want to be a promoter or you want to get something popping, like, your best time is your birthday. That's the one day out of the year everybody is forced to have the fuck with
you. That like, is, that's true.
Come out, whatever your coming out party going to be, whether you selling clothes, selling hair, selling lashes, rapping, whatever you're doing, everybody is forced to fucking, whether it's good or bad. Record
that is
shit,
so funny. Oh, that's
it, document it.
Yeah.
And you on your way.
And if they don't believe you, you got your story. Exactly.
Like, you know, I got my own crowd. Look.
Right.
Boom.
That's what you do for your birthday. It worked.
You know what I'm saying? I learned so much editing and being behind the scenes and knowing that, like, if you in control of the footage, you can make the story, you can change it and make it whatever the hell you want it to be.
Yeah.
Man, it was over with. Like, but at the same time, it's like on my teen club videos, like we ain't got none of them. So it's like Urban Myth type shit, for real, for real. But we really, every 2 weeks, was smacking shit out 600 to 800 people.
Yeah. No, I like that though.
But it's like, they know, you know what I'm saying? But then it's like now to still be able to do that and still produce. You feel me? Like Bow Wow, once when we was little Bow Wow and tried to be Bow Wow, you know what I'm saying? It ain't like, wait, work out for them. It'd be hard for the teens to actually continue and grow into it. And then, man, what? So like for me to be able to actually do it and make it and still be successful and doing what I'm doing, and it's only getting bigger. Cause now with me, the pandemic, like, wait, help me, cause I got to travel now. Like I was always so booked up, I couldn't even travel. Yeah. I was just stuck in Cleveland, you feel me? Like booked up, working week to week, doing these weeklies, and I gotta be here, and all this stuff going on in Atlanta and Florida and all these other places, I can't get to it. But people seeing me on Facebook, like, oh, I'm hearing about you. When they come to the city, they tap in, like, oh, they say, if you are who I gotta holler at, you know what's going on, where the party's at, boom, boom, boom. But I can't travel to your city to come rock with y'all. I'm like, man, if he could do it here, I mean, that's cool, but can he do it somewhere else? But I'm always booked.
Always booked, now, yeah.
And once now they it's shut opening up. Down,
yeah.
And I got to actually, because I was really supposed to drop right now last year at around the same time.
Yeah.
But then it was like, I dropped the initial trailer like March sometime. It was like March 7th. Yeah. And then that next week after that, that's when they shut the clubs down, shut everything down. Right. And I'm like, oh, this just fucked up. My God. Oh, I was about to boom, boom, boom.
Mess your whole plan up. Yep.
Hell yeah. I'm like, I'm about to do a strip club. I'm going to go to every strip club and boom, boom, boom. But then it helped me out, though, for real. Because I, like, DJs weren't never doing live reviews as much as they doing live reviews.
Now,
It was so many people that was easily accessible through the internet that I ain't had to leave. So then once I already made that connection, and then I got all these videos and everybody rocking with my song before the end. And best believe I got all y'all screen recorded, you know what I'm saying, and documented. Because it's all part of the, just like E-Feezy, DJ E-Feezy. He a big, you know what I'm saying, DJ in Miami. I can't even make this up. It was last month, I actually ended up getting a DJ with him and open up with him here in Cleveland because he's from Cleveland, but he DJ down there. But
making connections.
And then once when I had showed him the video, he's like, oh, I remember that. And he on there like, no, this song hard. Boom, boom, boom. And then I'm DJing at the spot. and it's another DJ in the city. That's a radio DJ. Mm-hmm. He up there with him, DJ, and I'm just playing my music. They're like, oh, that's you. I'm leaking new music. I'm like, oh no, that's hard.
That's right? Yeah.
I like what you're doing, man. You going, oh, and wrote me the next day. You know it's real when somebody writes you the next day after.
Yeah, when they reach out to you, they're like, listen, I'm gonna hit you up, and they hit you up immediately. That's how you know. So the pandemic kind of like helped you, you know, helped you make more connections.
Yeah, because it was like, now it's like, all right, it's only 20, 30 people in the live max at most times. So it's like, it's intimate. It's more intimate than going up to a DJ in a club, you feel me? And they like, oh, I can hear this in the club. So there's so many DJs that they never get to play it in a club and get that reaction. So now it's just extended the life of the song for real, rather than it being like, yeah, it would have been a heavy summer hit. It would have been a heavy summer hit last year. It would have been crazy. But now it's like, I done gave it to everybody. Everybody for sure got it. And now it's making its way. All I got to do, they like, when I went down to Atlanta, and this is the hardest song of the ATL Top 20 conference.
Yeah.
It's like, it's me and another dude's song. It's two of us. They're like, man, these the two hits out the weekend right here. Like, that's, it's awesome. All up to you and what you going to do with it. Like,
exactly.
Go crazy on TikTok. Or you could just keep it in a strip club and be a strip club hit. But it ain't just like boxed in. It's not that song you just box in and just be like, oh, this is just for this.
Right. It's a song you can use in many different avenues, you know?
Yeah. And then now that I just got I know you heard the Big Purr, right? The Big Purr song.
Yeah.
So the dude that did the Jersey Club remix, right? I linked up with him and got a Jersey Club edition right now. You feel me? So instead of doing a remix.
No, I think you sent it. Yeah, yeah.
Instead of doing the remix, you know what I'm saying? And throwing somebody on there, I'm just link up with another DJ and do that. And that's going to probably be the TikTok version of it. And it's going to go crazy, even crazier again. But like that, it was that I got hit to. It was the live reviews and then also the conference calls, though.
For sure,
like conference calls with like the DJ coalitions, like coalition DJs. I went through their whole little ring.
Their whole, exactly.
I went from Detroit to Atlanta to Philly to North Carolina, all of them. Like, and then it was crazy because the first one that I was a part of, it was like, I went on because I was supposed to be in there at a certain time. Then I came late. You know what I'm saying? They like, all right, we're going to squeeze one more in before we get our main artist. And the main artist of that day ended up being Erica Banks. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, yeah.
So they playing my music right before her. So it's like, I'm virtually opening up
for her. Yeah. Exactly.
And this before Busted, this before Shoot That, like this when they just getting ready to release them records, for real. So she up there rocking. They up there rocking. They like, oh no, you own them, son. Da-da-da-da-da. And like, man, your music, it reminds me of like some Beat King type, boom, boom, boom. This one name, like, where Beat King was starting to, I think Den Leave had just dropped. Or it was like starting a bubble. And everybody was comparing me to that. And I'm like, all right, they don't know. It's me for real. Like, so then after that, I actually stayed on the call. You feel me? You know, people perform, leave. Get to doing whatever.
You stay on trying to keep this connection.
I stayed on. And like, anybody else got any comments that they want to say for Erica? Like, shit, I'm still in this bitch, man. And then everybody started laughing and shit. Like, he cool as fuck. And then off then, it's like me and Coalition been locked in. And then I actually got to do a song with Erica. And we got.
Oh,
that's dope. Yeah, hell yeah. We got a banger.
So speaking of like all the connections that you've been 20, like the COVID, you've been using that to your advantage for sure. So like all the connections that you've been making, all the movements you've been making, like, so tell us what's next for Splash Rob. Like, what upcoming projects can we be looking out for?
I'm working on my OnlyFans right now. So ladies, hit me up. Y'all need a Scorpio.
Oh,
I'm taller on my back, you know what I'm saying?
You're only been, okay. I mean, if you...
But no, but all right. real nigga shit. I did go viral before doing some shit that I shouldn't have been, you know what I'm saying? And it wasn't me. I was literally the first rapper to like get head and rap at the same time. Like I was freestyling and get head and I put it up on the internet and shit. And I got a lot of good reviews, you feel me? Okay. But it was like, dude is dangerous. No, that, we can't have nothing you to do here. With him.
I can't.
But yeah, that's my past life, you feel me? That was eight, 7 years ago.
Moving forward
in the future, like, you know what I'm saying? I got, I'm just straight dropping singles. I'm just trying to get the visuals together and get a time, like, because you know everybody busy, you feel me? Erica Banks done went viral. I ain't got no letter. Erica Banks done went viral, got a song with her. B King done went viral, got a song with him. K Stylus done went viral, got a song with him. Lil Ronnie done went viral, got a song with him. So now everybody is working and busy. And I'm busy too still, because I'm DJing and trying to figure out wiggle when I can wiggle and now I'm traveling. So yeah, I got a song with Lil Ronnie. Song with Erica Banks. I got more, you know what I'm saying? More flame on the way. I got B King and K Stylus on the same fucking song, which is epic for the whole.
That's huge. Yeah.
Yeah. Then you know what I'm saying? My bro just got out, you feel me? We got music on the way. My dog Gutter Man. You know what I'm saying?
We make that shit together too.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I got music on the way with Dave B. You know, our in-house projects always come to crazy. So it's like, it's just a vibe. Like, we do this naturally, for real. We freestyle hits and all type of shit. So it's like, as long as you have fun with it, that's when, you know what I'm saying?
That's all that matters. As long as you have fun with it, you're passionate about it, the rest doesn't matter. It all falls into place.
So tell us,
where we can find you? Where do we find you? What's your
handle? You can find me on 131st Broadway.
Okay.
Ohio.
I mean, online. Where
do
we find you?
Oh, no. You know what I'm saying? All right. For real. Y'all can follow me at Party with Splash. Find me at Party with Splash. Everything Party with Splash. You feel me? I got a conflict of interest. I'm Splash Rob, but the brand is Party with Splash. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's wit. You know what I'm saying? No H. Wait,
okay, no H. Okay.
Yeah, you ain't gonna find me. You ain't gonna find me if you put an H on that wit. But it's only one me, man. I've been splashed forever. I've been splashed before Curry was hooping. You feel me? So
I can't. Before Curry was hooping. Very important. Make that distinction.
Yeah.
Before the Splash Brothers came along, it was
before the Splash Brothers came along, man, it was a splash ride. You feel me?
And right now is out, you know, you can find it on right Tidal, now. Apple,
hey man, 100K streams. Hold on, you said, what was the number again?
Over 115,000 streams.
Over 115,000 streams independently off the muscle, man.
Yep.
Off the muscle, man. It took a couple years, man, but that's what, you know what I'm saying? That's what happened when you authentic. This shit don't come.
Exactly.
Yeah.
There goes, and display your brand. Yeah, show your logo. Yeah, Party with Splash. There you go. That way they get the spelling right, you know? That way, exactly.
Man, I show, give y'all a little car show, you know what I'm saying?
Like, oh, hey, Lord. Okay.
These ain't no rentals, baby. You ain't never seen a whip like you.
Oh, my God.
With a custom tag. Okay.
What?
Yeah, man.
That's incredible. Yeah. No, definitely. Much blessings, much success to you, my brother. Like, thank you so much for coming on the podcast and speaking to me. It's been great just hanging out. It's been great just talking.
Hell yeah, you can call
for sure.
Me whenever too, man.
Very interesting. We'll have to get you back on for sure, especially as the hits keep coming. Like,
I wish nothing but success
to you.
Like, the crazy part is, this the whole method, though. You know what I'm saying? This the method right here. I got my hit myself. And get people familiar with me.
Yeah.
Now when I attach my brand to another brand, to all these other brands, and by the end of the year, shit, it's up. And I'm like, damn. Like, yeah, independently.
That's how you do it. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Keep it close to home.
And I'm putting the city on to see the thing is they love me because I show love. So that love gonna get reciprocated. Yeah.
Well, that's all, at the end of the day, that's all you can do is show love, you know?
Yeah, the niggas that's hating, they gonna be mad as hell when they gotta hit my
line.
They
stay mad. They stay mad. Listen, they stay mad.
You gonna have to come grease my palm. Like, damn, man, I know you about to tell me. Because you know the All-Star game out here this year.
Yeah, listen. Better be on it. Listen, make this connection. Yeah, no, that's awesome. I love everything you represent. I love what you do. You're funny, dude. I'm telling you, definitely to have your own little special coming out. I can see it in your future. Thank you again so much for joining us. It's been a pleasure having you on. We'll have to get you back on. As you said earlier, right now it's out everywhere. Check it out.
Everywhere.
Keep the blessings, you know, coming.
And I got the merch. I got the merch if y'all want to trip like this. You know what I'm saying?
Tell us where to find it. Where can we find the merch?
DoItDesigns.com, man. I got the hoodies up there right now. Don't mind that. I'm going to send you a whole care package. You feel
okay.
me? A whole care package. Just place your order on DoItDesigns.com. And I got you. I got the crew necks, the booty shorts,
listen,
the t-shirts,
the booty shorts,
the headbands.
You out here representing. Yeah, no, for sure. Definitely rock with your brand.
Better act like they know.
Okay. Oh my God.
That this is going to be the most entertaining interview you probably do all, motherfucker.
It probably will. It probably will be. But you know what? You kept me on my toes. You kept it interesting. It was great. It was amazing. Oh, yeah. Thank you so much.
BK Visuals presents.
What a world, you already know who it is. Cash Money Rich Gang Hood Rich Official. DJ Swamp Izzo. And I'm checking in because I got to shout out my boy, man. Congratulations, man. Number one strip club DJ.
Party with Splash.
Right now.
Bitch, bounce that ass.
Right now.
I got this cash.
Right now.
Might let me smash.
Right now.
Go ahead, get rat.
Right now.
Yo ass is fat.
Right now.
I want to smack.
Right now.
Bitch, do your dance.
Right now. Like right now.
Bounce that ass.
Right now,
shake that ass.
Right now,
bounce that ass.
Right now,
shake that ass.
Right now,
bounce that ass.
Right now,
shake that ass.
Right now,
bounce that ass.
Right now,
right now.
Harass a trending topic, that's a hash tag. Once I seen that ass, had to double tap. I might hit it once, but I won't double
back.
Bend it over, got behind it. Quarter back, throw it back like it's a Thursday. Fuck a snack, baby girl, you a entree. Better yet, a buffet. Got me in here throwing cake like it's your birthday. Yeah, it's your birthday. Ooh, it's your birthday. Bought her in the friend some drinks because they ass was thirsty. Pull up on the after this, take 480 to Broadway. Dark skin nigga, and I do it for the hoes. I ain't rude or banging preen, but little bitch, I do the most.
Hey, let the city booty bounce.
Splash rap, not Big Moose. Okay, girl, go buy some Gucci.
Yeah. Let the city booty bounce.
Just splash around, not Big Moose.
Throw some cash on me.
Okay, girl, go buy some Gucci. Bounce that ass. Shake that ass. 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 Party with Splash.
Right now.
Bitch, bounce that ass. Bounce that ass
right now,
shake that ass
right now,
bounce that ass
right now,
shake that ass
right now,
bounce that ass
right now,
shake that ass
right now,
bounce that ass
right now,
right now.
My favorite chocolate DJ.
Ohio zone, Cleveland, Ohio zone. Baby Slash, Slash Rob, what up, my boy? Listen, congratulations all the way from the A-Town. I can't wait till you get here and shut the whole city down. You know you got my 100% support. You already know what it is, man. Who it is? Rich Gang. Let's get it.
Ooh, that's just, that's just, that's just.
Let me grab my keys, hop in my ride. I gotta speak, coming down. this Ryan Engineer.
Yeah.
I swear to God this year, I touch more paper than a fucking cashier. These niggas hating on me, but I don't even care. Cause I got they bitches, yeah, they bitches right here. All of them cheer, they on my team this year. I touch more paper than a fucking cashier. I ain't playing games, no Xboxes over here. We been running trains on bitches over here. When I step out, splash sharper than a spear. I'm shining from the top just like a chandelier. Diamonds got them like headlights to a deer. In the club, I pop bottles, I ain't talking beer. Big bank roll full of 20s right here. Pop that pussy for me, she gon' twerk it over here. I'm Splash Rob, aka the man of the year. Only fuck niggas hate on me, let's get it clear. You couldn't be on my level if you stood on the chair. I talk a lot of shit and I can make it disappear. I fuck your bitch, dog, I don't play fair. This ain't that, ain't no cuffin' over here. I hopped in more hoes than Bugs Bunny this year. They say I'm been buzzing, but it been a light year. They mad how I come up with a hit every year. I go all in just like the Cavaliers. I'm from the city of the champs, shout out to the Cavaliers. Up the way, mobbing, got the hood in here. If you smoke high smoke, then put it in the air. Don't light up no Reggie, fucking up the atmosphere. I touch more paper than a fucking cashier. These niggas hating on me, but I don't even care. Cause I got they bitches, yeah, they bitches right here.
Go Splash.
Yeah, they bitches right here. All of them cheer, they on my team this year.
Go Splash.
Failed you, and how many times you
disgrace and gave your embrace.
You took my disgrace,
my sin you erased.
Lord, you took my disgrace,
my sin you erased.
You took my disgrace,
exchanged it for yours.
Grace, exchanged it for your amazing grace.
Frankie wanna blow up the bank.
Oh,
Frankie wanna rob the bank.